Good afternoon, good evening. How are we all? Just let me know in the comments on YouTube and Facebook. Sorry, my camera's over here, that you can see me. I will go in and have a quick test. Okay, Facebook looks like it's streaming and audio's okay. And YouTube looks the same. And I am back in. Oh, hang on. What's happening there? Oh, sorry. I'm showing the comments instead of hiding them. And if you haven't been on any of my recent Facebook Lives, I've been traveling. I've had an amazing 2.5 to 3 months. Video and audio is good. Hey, Jeff, how are you? But I am back in Mexico, back in Puerto Vallarta. And hey, Nancy, how are you? And I have my two screens. So I know when I've been traveling, it's been driving me crazy only having the one screen. I have actually been looking at getting one of these tri-screens. I don't know if you've seen them for the laptops. It's kind of a bit of kit that you place over the top of your laptop screen and it gives you two additional screens, plug it in, away you go. So I'm going to get one of those because I just struggle with it. So yeah, today we are going to dive on in. I'm going to just share my screen. We're going to be going through this doc. Why is that not showing the whole screen? It's kind of chopped off on the edges. Why is that? Anyway, it doesn't matter. So we're going to go through this document today. I'm going to give you this doc at the end. This is for more of the newbies or people who haven't been in the software for a while. We're going to kind of do a walkthrough of everything. As I say, I'll give you this doc at the end. And in this doc, each one of these steps has a hyperlink and it takes you straight to that training inside the Digital Academy. So it's nice and easy. You can go back through at your own pace. Here, there'll be nice videos that are recorded by Elliot, one of our team. But what we're going to do is we're going to dive in first. Sorry, let me get to the dashboard. And we're just going to do a little walkthrough just to get you familiarized with the software. As I say, some people who get on here are brand new. Others, you've been away, maybe bought it a year ago, and you just haven't had a chance to use it. So either way, please ask questions. Try and keep them relevant to the bits that we're on and obviously try and remind me of the bits that we're on. If I'm in Groove Pages and you've got a question about that, make sure to include it in the question because there's a 10-15 second delay with StreamYard. I might have moved on and I've kind of forgotten what the question is you're asking about. So yeah, so let's just start off with in the top right corner, you're gonna have your, it's either gonna be an image of the icon if you haven't added an image or your image. In here, you've got your settings and billing Groove Partner Program. If we open up the Partner Program, you're automatically given access to be an affiliate with Groove when you register an account. So this will open up, because I'm already logged in over here, this will open all the information relating to my specific account. It'll be the same for yours. Little video here from Mike walking you through everything. And then the promotion tools will load. These will be all of my promo tools, all relevant for me. And then you can look at the rest of the page here. Obviously you have the settings billing. We're going to go through those. When you click on the four dots here, it opens up all of the apps so you can access them everywhere around the website. Same here, if you hover on the Groove icon here, you can click on any of those. Here you have your latest updates. So you can see here we have different announcements, and these are some of the videos I've done with new features, feature improvement, code refinements, etc. And here, this is our GrooveCM AI assistant. It's our little AI bot. Go in here and challenge him, ask him questions. So let's just put custom domain. And he normally spits out the correct information. If you ask him a question that's a little bit more detailed than setting up a custom domain, you can see he's giving you all the info pretty much straight away. If he doesn't give you the correct answer, or you believe it's not the correct answer, take a screenshot of what he's given you, send us the question you asked, and send it over to our support team so that we can input that question. We can input the correct answer. We want him to be able to give you all the answers within Groove. Obviously, the software is being updated. It's being improved all the time. So sometimes he's a little bit behind the scenes or behind where the software is. If you are looking to promote Groove, you should click on either your affiliate URL just to see the upgrade page, or you can just click there. This is the upgrade page. Obviously, I've got a lifetime account, but it's saying I can increase to lifetime unlimited leads. Here is another video from Mike explaining what the software is about and the upgrade. But it's worth scrolling through here, having a look. And also, what's really cool is Mike and the team have put all these side-by-side comparisons to help you make decisions. But again, if you're looking to promote, you need to know where your users are going to be going to after they've set up a free account. Here you can access the affiliate program again. I'll go to the sidebar now. As we said, you can access all the apps from here. And again, you'll see a running theme through all the apps. You'll have a little sidebar here with these little icons. Just hover on each one. It's going to give you a little explainer. So this is where you can click into the affiliate marketplace. So if you are an affiliate marketer and you want to promote additional products, you can come in here and search for those. For example, like Groove AI. If I hadn't already been promoting Groove AI, it would show join program here. Then I can see the offer. I can click on grab my links. I can grab all the promo tools, or I can go to the sign up page. I can search within here, or I can go to different categories or billing types, and I can find products that I can promote. Alternatively, if you are someone that has your own product or your own service and you want to promote it through Groove Affiliate, when you set up in GrooveSell, which we're going to get to, you can activate the affiliate setup and you can add all your own promo tools. You can get it ready for other affiliates to promote your product, which is phenomenal. So here we have our services. So you can set up a Groove Pay account. And I apologize, my throat is still a little bit tickly. I've got a bit of a frog in my throat. I've just been traveling for nearly 3 months in Bali and Indonesia. And then I've just come back from the marketers cruise with Mike Fulsaine, Donna Fox, Tom Beale, and 450 other amazing marketers. And it is intense. My throat is just blown out because, excuse me, you're constantly networking on the ship. You're meeting other business owners, entrepreneurs. It is phenomenal. So GroovePay, you can go and apply here. Groove Solos, you can buy solo traffic. Just go and create a free account here. And you can also become an affiliate for that. If you haven't used solo traffic, it explains everything here. Events and workshops, excuse me. I would recommend you register for our 2024 GrooveCon. And obviously you can see it here, the Marketers Cruise 2025, January. We're going from Port Canaveral this year. I've already booked my cabin. You can see it's 360 days away. And it is obviously organized by Captain Lou, Mike Fulsaine, and Tom Bill. 70% fun in the sun, 30% business building. I'm running a mastermind next year for all the people who book cabins through me. So if you're interested in that, feel free to contact me. Here's your API key. You can change the language from English to Portuguese. And here you have the Digital Academy. Again, we're gonna go through all of these. But you can open it up and you can go into the app specific for training videos, or you can start typing something in over here. Sorry, my internet's going a bit slow. and it'll bring you up all the relevant options. Then you have the help desk, and here the AI bot will pop up again. And give him a minute. There he is. I must have dragged him there last time. All right, I'm just going to get rid of him. Here you've got your chat. Again, we're going to go into those. And here you can search the knowledge base. And last but very much not least is the feedback and roadmap. So obviously, we want to know where there's glitches inside of any of the applications. Some of the features that you feel would be valuable to go inside some of the applications. You know that we've done a huge code refinement over the last 4 to 5, 6 months. You know some of the things that are happening, but we're still looking for you guys to tell us what you think is needed within specific apps. So you can see here, you can come in here and search and see if someone else has already added, for example, image library improvement, folders, bulk upload. So you can see that this is a planned feature now. And each one of these you can vote for. So if you search, let's say you wanted to add exactly that, or you find that someone's already added it, you just need to go and vote for it. You can see I've already voted this one. And because many people have voted for it, it's now planned. If you can't find, let me see if I can find one that I haven't voted for, just to show you. Obviously, I'm a user like you, so I vote for all of these ones that I feel are relevant and needed in here as well. But you get the gist. Oh, there you go. So sequence email. So if I click vote there, it's going to obviously take that up one. But if I can't find what I'm looking for the feature request, go over here, add it, maybe record a Loom video, give us as much information as possible, and it'll get added to this list. Updates you can access over here as well. That's all the update videos. Bug reporting, really important. Again, go and search for it first because someone else may have already reported this bug. It may have been reported 2 or 3 times. People might have already voted for it. Same thing here, you can vote for it. And again, if you haven't seen that the bug is already being reported over here, go over here, give us a lot of information, a lot of detail. Again, my recommendation, record a Loom video. Loom is just a free Chrome extension. You can see it here, I've just clicked on it. It's going to try and take over my camera, so I'll get rid of it. But, you know, it's worth recording a Loom video to explain what the bug was. Show us live. That helps us then fix it. And then we have articles here on the end. In fact, I've got a feeling that's quite new because I don't remember ever seeing that. That does look like it could be new. Anyway, let me come back to the dashboard. Here at the top, you can see there's the quick links. This will be different programs, different softwares, different recommendations. You've got all your quick links here. So if you click directly, this can take you through to that specific app. Or if you click on the three dots, you can go then direct into checkout forms, for example. Okay. And then when you see this loading, the top loads very quickly. And then the bottom does what's called a lazy load. So if you've got all your stats and everything down the bottom here, that will lazy load. So that is everything in the dashboard. Any questions on that just to get us started? And I'm gonna have a mouthful of water because my throat is really struggling. Oh, excuse me. And also feel free to just comment and let me know where you're tuning in from. Always more beneficial for me running one of these live trainings having you interacting with me. Otherwise, I feel like I'm just sat here talking to myself, running through these 17 questions. Or not questions, 17 steps. Jeff Nettles from Naples, Florida. Oh, good to see you, Jeff. I've just been over in that part of the world. I've just flown back from Miami. I do love Miami. Okay, so I'm going to dive into the first one. As I said, I'm going to give you a copy of this doc at the end. Remind me. And each one of these, when you click on it, you just click that and it hyperlinks through. So the first one is an easy one, editing or adding account details in Groove. Just click on your little icon, click settings and billings, and you've got everything here. You can go in and modify all of these. I'm not going to open them all up because obviously there are private information of mine. You can change your image over here. It will open up. So that is the first one, really simple. So how to update affiliate payment information, quite an important one. So let's go back in the settings and billing. Let's go into affiliate settings here. This will be the username you created. This is my business name, Funnels Qualified, my funnel and website agency. And this is the affiliate ID I was given when I signed up. So mine is 4042. You will need to go into here and add your payment information, either PayPal or wire transfer. And you will need to complete the tax info, probably create, if you're not living in the US, you will need to complete one of those forms. I'm not going to open those. It's got all of my information, but it's very easy to do. We get a lot of tickets complaining they haven't been paid their affiliate commissions after they've made their first two sales. And we often find that they just haven't completed these informations, either their payment info or tax info. We need both of those completed before we can actually pay you an affiliate commission. So I hope that makes sense. Step number three, setting up a payment gateway in GrooveSell. Really easy. We'll go into it this way. You're going to come in again. You're going to see a running theme down the left sidebar. All of these will open up when you click on them. You're going to click on settings and it opens up with payment gateways. You can obviously click to add and you can add any of these, Stripe, AuthorizeNet, NMI, PayPal, Paystack, etc. And they're really easy to, once you click on it, it's going to open up and tell you what it needs. So you're going to name it probably Stripe and maybe your business name if you've got more than one business like I have. You're going to put your publishable key and your secret key, which you're going to get from Stripe. And then you can do the same with AuthorizeNet. Each one you'll see will ask for different information, but very, very simple to set up and very simple to add. So those are nice, easy ones to get us going. Step number four, setting up a payment gateway in GrooveCart. Pretty much exactly the same process, just in a different application. So we're clicking the GrooveCart here. GrooveCart's actually the only app I physically do not currently use, although I am setting up a store for my Temecula events business where we rent out bell tents and bars, and my Paddle app that I'm just about to launch. We've set up started setting up a store in here as well. So by the end of this month, I'll have a live GrooveCart store. So when you come in here, just click settings. Payment gateway is pretty much exactly the same as in GrooveSell. And again, you can set up a Groove Pay account or you can apply through here. That's going to open up a new window. And then you can go in and set up all of it. You'll see there are a few different ones, a few additional ones. You can set up cash on delivery for the store. And again, you just go in here to activate them. Really, really simple. And what you will notice is it opens up an additional window in GrooveCart. So I'll go back there. So this is probably step number five, probably the most commonly asked question is how to add a custom domain. And we're going to do this live. I've set up, I've got logged in my GoDaddy account. So I'm going to grab a domain that I know I'm not using. Two different ways you can get into this. You can either come in through Groove Pages, and once you in there, when you go into setting up your settings, you can do it there. Or the easier way is just to come to settings and billing, click domains, leave it set on the custom domain. We're going to click manage, and then you're just going to click add new domain. And you can see there's five steps that you've got to complete. It's really simple. So I'm going to use which one? This one. I'm going to go into my DNS. I should have gone into manage, but DNS is fine because we want to get into our name servers. And this is my new business I'm setting up in Bali. So I'm just going to copy that and I'm going to click name server because it's going to ask you in a moment. We're going to leave it as full domain, subdomain setup. It's recommended. Legacy is setting up manually through Cloudflare. I don't recommend that. That was how we used to have to do it. This is really easy now. Click next. I'm going to paste in that URL and you can see I've got no www dot in front of it or anything. The HTTPS is already here. Click next. It's now going to tell us that we need to go and grab these two name servers, as you can see here, and we need to add them into our domain provider. I use GoDaddy. It's just one I've used for 25 years. In fact, I'm going to delete those. Maybe I've already used this one. Let me grab a different domain. It looks like I've already used that one as a demo because it's a brand new domain. I've only just bought these after visiting Bali. Sorry. GoDaddy's changed everything and it's made it a little bit more complicated. I don't like it, I've got to be honest. I'm just going to grab a domain I know I'm not using. to try this one, Maktub. Don't think I've used this. I'm just going to go back to my domains. I'm going to just delete that one just because I don't want to be adding one that I think I've already maybe already added. So I'm going to go into this one, DNS. It'd be worth me checking the name servers first. So you can see these are the GoDaddy standard ones. So I haven't started editing this one. So let's use this one. You can see I've removed it there. So we're going to just start again, next. I'm going to paste that domain in and click next. I'm going to grab Dora Major. It's normally Dora Major. I like these guys, and I'm just going to go into change name. So what I was saying was whatever domain provider you have, they'll give you instructions on how to change the name. So it's not complicated. You can see here, I'm just pasting. I'm copying here, and I'm just pasting this in. And you can go back and watch this and slow this down. It's going to ask me, am I sure? Yes, I know what I'm doing. That's fine. Now, normally, what will happen here is if I refresh this page, it normally tells me those name servers have been updated. But 99% of the time when I actually do this training, so Dora and Major will probably be there already. There they are. But when I go to the last few steps here to validate the DNS or the domain, it doesn't always work as quickly. So we normally come back to this. So we're going to click validate DNS. It will normally come up with a yellow box. So it's saying it's not ready yet. That's fine. We'll click complete the process. We need to come back here to click to verify. Okay. So just remind me, don't let me forget that I've got to come back here because the next step, step number six, I cannot do this until we come back. So once you set up your domain, your website in Groove, you can now set up your professional email account, either in Google, in Zoho, whatever provider you want. I use Google. So it could be Rob at, what was the domain I added? That was gone. Rob at Maktub.com. Then you need to come back in here and add some settings that either Google will give you or whatever your domain provider is, text settings, MX records, CNAME records. So I need to do this when we come back at the end. So remind me of that, please, please, please. So let's go and have a little walkthrough now of all the apps. So let's go to Groove Affiliate first. I'm going to access it over this side and just click into Groove Affiliate. Again, you'll see the same will happen every time. The sidebar will load with all of your activities over here. This will load in the middle. So when you come into Groove Affiliate, you can see you can do date ranges. So let's do yesterday, and you can see that will change. Or you can go in and manually modify the date ranges. You can come in here and add different filters if you want. You can reset, refresh. You've got total sales only and rebills, and it's currently showing a revenue view. So you can see that here. If I remove the toggle, it'll show remove the revenue view. It'll give me visitors, signups, initial sales, new sales, refunds, cancellation. So you can toggle that on and off. Then when you come over here, we click in promotions and links, and these will be all the things that you are able to promote. If you've just arrived, then you'll probably just have the GrooveCM legacy. You can click on the links here and you can access your links directly. I recommend the first time you come in here, you just do a test. Now, my affiliate ID is 4042, but you will notice when you're grabbing this link, it doesn't have that there. It's got all this code at the end. So I recommend the first time you just come in here so you can see that. If I paste that there and then press enter, I want to just do a double check. Does it show me affiliate af underscore ID equals 4042? Okay, it does. So that now tells me that the cookies are tracking to me. And if you want to do a secondary check, just go here and click get started. It'll take you down here where people can register for a free account. And then just check that it's got your referrer name. You can see that's my business name, Funnels Qualified. You only really need to do it once. You're just checking that that link is taking them to the correct place, and then it's dropping that cookie in so that it's going to track back to you. Here you can see you can access affiliate bonuses. Many people who promote Groove don't even realize you can add a bonus, and it's really simple to add. You just click in promo tools and click bonuses, click new bonus. I call it a name, and then I just go into Groove pages and I create a delivery page where I'm going to add the URL in here. It's kind of a hidden page. It's not live anywhere. And I can add that either in a welcome email if they've signed up, or I can add that here, and this will automatically then send it when I send them to it. So for example, back in promos, when I click here, when I click into bonuses, you can now see that all of these bonus pages or bonuses that I've got will be available. If I go into the paid version, I've got an upgrade bonus where I think I give $7,000 worth of free bonuses. On the free version, I give $2,000. That gets delivered automatically to my users. And you can see, you can add additional products you want to sell. So you can see I promoted Groove AI, etc. Here you have your reporting, your transactions, your sub affiliates, your earnings reports. Here you can come in and set up tracking links. This is pretty straightforward. You just click on create a tracking link. It's going a bit slow. Here you can go into the marketplace again where we've already looked. And then here again, you have your settings where we went into the settings and billings over here. You have your payment and tax info. Make sure you complete those. And my recommendation, if you are doing affiliate marketing, is always create a bridge page in front of it. This isn't a training on that. And if you don't know what that is, then don't worry. But give away some bonuses, because otherwise you're just the same as everyone else who's giving away a free account with Groove. You're not giving any additional value. There's lots of people out there giving away free accounts and being affiliates. You know, add a bonuses page. Also, then it means you're grabbing their name and email before they go to our affiliate link. Hope that makes sense. So Groove blog, let's click in here. Groove blog's had a lot of updates, it's gonna get more, but you know, for me, it's very functional. Is it WordPress? No. Are we trying to be WordPress? No. Do we want it to run a functional blog so that you can have everything in under one umbrella? Yes. And this is a live blog. This is my events company in Temecula that we run, and I'm gonna go into settings first. So you can go in here and modify all your SEO. You can obviously add your domains. I've got this set up on a folder. So it's temeculaeventscompany.com/blog. And it should be live. If I open that up, that's the live blog there. We'll come back to. You can obviously go in and add your logo, your favicon, your social links, your comments. Here you can add different forms. So you obviously you have to have created them in Groove form, but then you can change the styling within Groove blog. The copyright now, you have a year, it's dynamically changes, and also you can add hyperlinks to take people elsewhere. You can add your embedded ads, your tracking pixels, your OG and your metadata, which is again really important, and you've got all your RSS settings. You can share specific pages or all pages, posts, etc. In fact, I like to do this. So if I come here first, it shows the blog, and then when I click navigation, now you can actually see where this top navigation is. It's here. So you can see people can click into bar hire, bell tent hire, and weddings. They've got the 10% discount button is here. I normally get asked, this chat bot is not part of Groove. It's an external chat bot that I've added on our website and on our blog, and it's a pre-qualifier. So it's AI for the first 7 to 10 questions, which is just pre-qualifying these people. And then it asks, would you like to be handed over to one of our team? And it puts it through to one of our sales team in Temecula. And, you know, we cut out all the time wasters, but also we help people answer a lot of questions on here. You can see we have the privacy and reviews down the bottom here. And also you have categories, which you can see at the top. So we have different categories here. Same thing, you can delete, add all of these over here. Themes, we don't have many themes at the moment, but more will be coming. But you've got to realize you can customize this pretty much to your heart's content. So you can change all the font. You have all the access to all of the fonts that are now available in Groove pages. You can come in here and change different colors. So you can see if I change that red, it would change the color immediately. It's like it's a bit dark. Let me go back to what it was. You can also go into the layout. So on the home page, I can remove the sidebar, categories, opt-in forms, etc. I can modify all of this. I can go into the actual page, same thing. I can toggle some of these on or off. And also I can go into the category page and again, do whatever I want in there. I'm gonna go back to the home page. So pretty straightforward, really easy to use. I'm gonna exit out without saving. You can go directly into the categories here, add new, edit, modify, etc. And you have the posts. When you first set up a blog, it will give you 5 dummy posts. I just recommend you open one in an editor. just go in here and just click on and modify the headline, change some text, change the image. You can go in now in the images. It's ready. So I'm getting too fast. You can change the alt tags, etc. in here now. It's got lots of updates. If you want to add something, you should press return and then you click the plus button. You can add additional things. And then over here, you're obviously going to go in and modify your featured image, the post URL slug, the date, the categories. You can add the keywords here. And then you've got a little excerpt that shows up. Again, you can remove any of these that you don't want. You can add your metadata and your open graph data specifically for this blog post, which again, I recommend. So when people share this, this is what will be popping up. And you have your custom code down the bottom. So pretty straightforward. I'm going to exit out of there without saving. And you can see, obviously, we've got plenty of those in here. And then you finish off with just, you can either visit the blog, as you can see, we've got it open up over here, or you can just publish. So that is Groove Blog. Let me get rid of that. And you can see this pop up when someone leaves, it pops up and it gives them an agent they can speak to, etc., which is kind of cool. We just realized we were losing a lot of people who were just shopping around. As soon as we answered 4 or 5 questions, they were more engaged. They were more likely to give us their name and email, and it grew our list. And then those people did come back and buy. So it just makes sense. So that's Groove Blog, Groove Cart. Sorry, I nearly jumped one. So Groove Cart, as I said, this is the only one that I'm currently, you haven't got anything live, although we have got some that we're building. So I'll go into this one just because we've started building it out. My team are building out a store to sell paddle rackets, paddle equipment, paddle merchandise that's going to be connected to our application. And when you first come in here, same thing, you're seeing a running theme around all the apps now. But just follow these 6 steps first, really simple. Then once you've done these, go and add your domain, your legal pages. You can go in and design your store, go and set up your email templates, and then you'll have all your stats at the bottom here. So what I love about Groove Cart, you have a extension. I can't actually see it. Google's done an update recently. Oh, there it is. So you can add this extension, the AliExpress to Groove Cart. So it means if you're on AliExpress and you see a product that would fit for your store with that extension, where's it gone? It's here somewhere. You can just click the button there and it will add that product directly into your store, add it into my products. You've also got your categories, your discounts, your product of the day and your drop shipping. Here you can go into all your orders, your subscriptions, your abandoned carts, customers, your help desk and your affiliates. And then now you can go into the builder. So when you first set up a Groove Cart store, you'll add the name. It will take 5 to 7 minutes because it's kind of building this out for you. It builds all of this stuff. So you can see here, we've done nothing on here apart from my team have come in and added some of these products that I've already tested. So I've ordered them from the provider in China through AliExpress. I've got all these downstairs as tester rackets. Once I'm happy that the company sent them out, done everything right, I've got good communication with them. Now we're adding them as drop shipping products so that when someone orders this, it goes direct to the provider. Obviously, these prices we haven't amended yet. We'll add our markup onto these. Let's say this racket I get for $150, I might be selling it for $400. And that order goes direct to the drop shipper. They put all my branding on it. They put the invoice receipt from me. They send it out to the client with the price the client paid. I never have to touch that product, which is phenomenal. So you can see we've added a few things here. We need to modify all of this. We've added some merchandise. We'll be selling t-shirts, shorts, paddle bags, etc. And you can click into all of these, and obviously they're all editable, every single thing. I can manage this by clicking into the settings. I can change these out, remove them. I can click into blocks. I can add blocks, etc. So just go and play. My recommendation, if you're new, any single one of these apps, just go in and play for 30 minutes to an hour. You know, set up a Groove Cart store and then come back in and kind of try and break it. Just click into everything, figure out what happens there, what happens here, what if I do this? You kind of can't break it because you've got the back button here, so you can always go backwards. You've got the different layouts, so you can view it in mobile, tablet, etc. You can add new blocks, elements, global elements. You can see all of this very much like Groove Pages. You can go into all your different pages here. So I can go in and modify. I'm not going to save that. I can go in and modify my category page when someone clicks into a category, into a product page. And again, all of this is editable. So you can do all of that. You see the shipping cart, the checkout, you can modify all of them. You can go into your navigation. So if I went back to the home page, you'll see at the top here. So I can go and modify my navigation. I can add, I can remove, I can drag these around. I can add pop-ups now in Groove Cart as well. Here is where we can go and modify our themes. We've got our different themes here as well. And then you've got your SEO settings, your template settings. So you can go in and do, look, you can see all of these different templates. You've got all your SEO settings, the same as in within Groove Pages. So just go in and play. You know, there's nothing that can get broken here. You can just read everything, click to edit header, boom, go in and play with it and see what you can produce. So that's Groove Cart. And the next one is Groove Mail. Again, unless you've been under a rock or on the moon, you will know that we've had some major challenges with Groove Mail over the last year. Got launched about a year or so ago. We had a lot of unscrupulous people that added lists full of spam email. So obviously our deliverability got hit, our servers got hit, everything got hit. So we had to close it down completely. David Lemon's working with a team of new devs because the old devs, they were terrible. Mike Phil Same's done many lives about this and he's explained it and come out and told everyone exactly what happened and where they messed up. They're now completely rebuilding. And we are hoping that this is going to be coming back very soon. I'm going to put demo mode on. Again, in the dashboard, you have demo mode here. So if you're doing training videos, you're not showing any client information. So for example, if I click on contacts, I always keep my fingers crossed just because it's software. You never know. So you can see here, it hides it all. But you could then do a demo and show clients how you can, you know, go and view and edit and delete and stuff like that. Here you can go into your lists, your tags, your categories, your segments. So again, you can see each one of these has a refresh. So it saves this loading really slowly. So for example, if I wanted to refresh here, if there'd been any new people adopted in, it would change. Here you have your broadcast, your sequences. Sequences is pretty cool. So in a sequence, for example, let me go into our Temecula events prize draw. We do a monthly prize draw. It's just a way to get people into our list. So you can see the triggers here. People will get added to this sequence if they have a tag applied, if they get added directly into a list, or if they go directly for a form. And we've just got some conditional splits set up. So if someone purchases through one of our orders, order pages, or buys a product, they then get removed from this list. They get added to the purchase list. They get unsubscribed from this list. If they don't buy, then we wait 24 hours. We send them another email with another little nudge. Same thing. If they buy, we remove them. We don't bother them. If they don't buy, we send them another email a day later, another email a day later, another. And these are just nice little value emails. It's just a little touch base with our client just to make sure that they haven't forgotten about us. So that was campaigns. Automations, you can go and set up campaigns in here. They are if-then scenarios. So if someone subscribes to a list, I want this specific thing to happen. And every time you set one up, it automatically goes to red. So then you have to click resume and it will go green. I'm going to leave that one turned off. My team obviously have that off for a reason. Forms, David Lemon already has relaunched forms and he's rebuilt them from the ground up. So let's go into my test one. In the early version of the forms, you couldn't really modify everything. It was very awkward. It was a bit glitchy. Now you can modify in the build form section. In the design form section, you can make it look and feel exactly how you want. You can obviously go through this process and go through the setup. What lists do you want to add them to? What tags, what sequences, what opt-ins? Do you want it to send a welcome email? All of the good stuff. And then you have your integration. So now you can have someone, if they opt in somewhere, for example, this one, they're getting added to my CryptoBot Passive Profits program. They get instantly sent out the membership credentials. So again, really easy. You can add your integrations, your webhooks, and files. People forget you can add files direct in here. So again, really, really cool. So go and play with forms. Senders, when you are using Groove Mail, you will need to add a sender. And if I go into create a new sender, you obviously add your sender identity, your name, etc., the email you want it to go to and from, make sure it's a professional email. And then you'll see that I am able to use GrooveMail SMTP. You are not, because obviously we've got it shut off right now whilst we're rebuilding it. But you can use Mailgun, SendGrid, Spark Post, or Amazon SES. I've used SendGrid for many years, used Amazon SES. Each one of these is going to tell you what information they need. There's a video guide on all of these as well. So SendGrid needs you to add the API key from SendGrid, and then you take this webhook and add this back into SendGrid. They're all slightly different. Go in and watch the video and set that up. And then you'll add your business info, your company name, and your address on the back there. And then that will create your sender. You can also add recipient. So you can add it where it triggers an email to someone every time you get an opt-in, which you'll get very bored of very, very quickly. Again, you've got your quick links at the top, your broadcast sequences, etc. And then you've got all your stats down the bottom here. So that's Groove Mail. Groove Member. Groove Member, I think people underrate. You can do a lot in Groove Member. I've got all of my memberships set up in Groove Member. Some are still in Groove Member 1.0 because they've upgraded it massively. And we're having to move those across. Same running theme here, quick links, etc. So you can click on here to your memberships. This is a new membership we're setting up. This is our Paddle app that we're giving some free training with. And we're also doing a VIP where we give additional trainings. So if I click in here, this is where it will go the very first. Hang on. No, sorry. I've done that wrong. Should have gone in. What am I doing? Yeah, the first time you come in, it's going to look slightly different. But then once you're in here, you can customize your membership site. You can add additional courses. You can manage access levels. You manage your members, manage your settings, all your analytics. So you can see here. A membership, you can add more than one course inside, okay? And again, if I come back here and go in and customize, we've started the build on this. This is our Paddle Fanatics members area. And again, you can see the different layouts. We've got a little welcome message here. And then again, we can go in now and add pages. So you can see at the top here, we've got our home support. We can add probably some additional pages over here. We can go into the navigation, modify that, the footer, the logo. We've got templates we can add in here. We've got all of our settings, our label settings, etc. And obviously most of this is uneditable down here, but you can go in here and like you see, we've added this background. We've got the welcome text, etc. And we've got all the edit settings. Same thing, you've got, you know, once you've been in Groove Pages, Groove Cart, they're all got the same kind of layout. You can change the views, etc. You can have a back button, you've got a forward button, and you have a preview button, which will open up a new window, and you have your saved over here. So we come back out of there and come back into the membership areas. Here we have courses, so you can add as many courses as you want, and you can add those to as many memberships as you want. You have your portals, which again is quite cool. It means you can have more than one course or more than one membership on your portal. So for example, I don't know if this is live. This is very old now. Oh, it is, yeah. So here we can see I have a free giveaway, which is the Profit Funnel Business, where I give you a free funnel. And if someone clicks on that, I presume it goes to the members area. Yeah, because obviously I'm logged in and it's free. So it should open up. Let me just check. Yeah, so this is the members area to the Profit Funnel Business. This shows them and walks them through how they can grab the funnel. And then other things, I haven't been running the 10-day Groovy Challenge. I need to take some of this stuff down. But for example, if they haven't already bought my crypto bot, then they can click here. And now this takes into the sales page because it recognizes that the person that's logged in or not logged in doesn't have access. So then it's going to potentially sell more of your stuff. So again, I think I've got this still running on auto webinar. It's always good to check these things whilst I'm going through and doing these lives, because some stuff we have, so it is running on auto webinar. But it's just a good way to sell additional products that these people might not have seen. That's the portal. Here again, I think people forget you can add all your files in here. You can store them. You can grab a URL. So if you want to give this away on a thank you page, on a button, or you want to add it into an email, you can grab a document if that's what you're doing. You've got your categories. Here you can set up all your instructors and here you have members. I'm not going to click on members because in here, for some reason, it doesn't have demo mode, and I don't always like to gamble on it. And then we've got all your analytics over here. So same thing, got quick links and all your stats here as well. But go and play with Groove Member. It really is cool. Groove Pages, I could spend hours on Groove Pages. And we'll have a little pause. Any questions, please fire them in. Otherwise, I will continue. I'll give you a few seconds. For those that did join late, feel free to ask questions. Try and keep them related to the apps that I'm currently on. And always remind me of what I was talking about because there's a 10-second delay on StreamYard. So, for example, we've just come into Groove Page. I'm just going to do a little walkthrough. So the first time you come here, you're going to click on New Site. I'm just going to click on, let's go to this one. This is my new website I'm building for my new business in Bali. I've just bought a plot of land with a business partner in Bali, and we're building a resort. So I just kind of built this out whilst I was in Bali. Just to give you, this is me and my business partner. And you can see here, obviously we haven't built the resort yet. We're literally just signing the paperwork in the next day or so to take ownership of it. I kind of built this and then used AI to kind of design some of the villas and the layout and the look that I want. This is kind of like the view. This is pretty much exactly like the view that is from our plot. And you can see here, all of these pictures are AI, and how good do they look? These are all built within Groove AI. These are the look and feel of some of the villas we're going to be creating. So I've kind of got a ready-made store that, not store, a website that is nearly finished, and we haven't even broken ground yet, which is kind of awesome. I love AI, it's phenomenal. And all of the content that's written on here, I've done from within Groove AI, but you can do it with ChatGPT as well. So as we come in here, we go across the top. We have all of these different layouts. You can click on any of these. And what's important here is that this little toggle here, if I leave this selected, every time I edit something, it edits on all the different screens. But let's say, for example, I think this is too big, this one bit of text here. I can deselect this and you see it will change, applying changes to mobile device only. Now let's say I click on this text and I make this tiny, tiny, tiny small just to prove a point. And then when I go back over here, you'll see it hasn't changed anywhere else. It's only changed on the mobile view. And obviously my favorite button, the back button, if I don't like it, I just click back until it returns. So yeah, so you can go in and do that. Back button's my favorite button, the forward button. You have the preview button, so that can then preview the URL. It is a preview and it won't show you, it pop up here. It won't have the links working, etc. But it's good to just preview the site, see how it looks, etc. But you'll see that these won't work, these buttons. So a better way to preview, in my opinion, is once you've already published, is just click over here and you can see it. It'll just open up that window, but it will give you the specific URL, and then it will mean that all of this is clickable. Hope that makes sense. Whilst we're there, you have your save button. Also, you have your publish button. This is where you can also manage your domains. We showed you earlier how you can access these. So if I wanted to add one of these over here, then I come through that process. Hosting options, you can then obviously have custom domain or group pages subdomain. If you want a custom domain, you then just click the drop down and you'll see all the domains that you've got added. And then you can add it as a root domain, which means it's on the main URL. Sorry, get rid of that. Or you can add it as a subdomain. I've added this as a root domain. This is our business name, Maktub Destiny Solutions. And then you publish the website, which means all the pages in there, or you can just publish this one page. So now when we're on the page, you can see when I'm hovering, it's going red. So it's kind of telling you what you're highlighting on. So if I want to edit this text here, I just click the button. Now I've got some options that pop up over here. And also this sidebar opens. You can obviously collapse that if you want, just so you can see more things. But if you're modifying everything in here, again, set yourself up a dummy site and go in and play. Don't build your first site for a site that you want live in a week. You know, just go in here and play with all of this, you know, modify all of this stuff, mess around with it. What happens here if I do this and this and this? And, you know, I shouldn't really be doing this on here, but and just open up each one of these. Let's modify the background. So you can see here, I've got a background of an image, borders, animations, delays, spacing, sizing. And each time all of these settings are specifically for this H1 tag, this text box here. If I think, well, actually, no, I want to work inside this container, I can see down here in the breadcrumbs, I can click here, or I could have just clicked this little arrow here and it will do the same thing. But let's say I want to click into the block and change all the settings in the block. Okay, now I can see. So when you're highlighting, sorry, when you've got nothing open, see how it's got green? So it basically means that I've probably modified this, which I have, because obviously I've got an image as the background. So it's kind of giving you a little hint that shows you that I've probably modified the spacing. So yeah, each time you're in the settings for this specific area, this specific text block, this specific button, these settings, now I can change the spacing. Yeah, and that's spacing on the side of the text, etc. So I'm gonna click out of this and I'm just gonna come back out, and it should ask me, do I wanna leave without changing anything? Just because I started messing around with stuff. So you shouldn't really do that. If you've got a live site, you shouldn't really be messing around in there, but I'm gonna go back in just in case. Where was it? And then down on the left-hand side, you've obviously got your other little drop down. You've got pages, so you can go in and modify the pages. Here you can see pages that you want to show in the navigation. Here are hidden pages. You can add funnels in here, and you just go in and click add, and it'll open up funnels. Here you can click into webinars, and the same thing, you can go and add any pre-built webinars. Pop-ups, same thing, add your pop-ups. And then global blocks, so you can create your own global blocks, etc. So here we have blocks, and you can go into, like, for example, modern, and click on each one of these. It'll give you 20 different variations. There was 300 or so added 3-4 months ago, wireframe. So for example, for a newbie, direct response category, look, this alone, this kind of text box would take you 20, 30, 40 minutes to create, maybe longer as a newbie. You can click this button, it'll just add it. You've got all your pop-ups, your mega menus, and then obviously you can save any block you want. So you can see all of these blocks are from my 10-day Groovy challenge. All of these blocks that I've saved here would be something else. This is a different funnel. So you can save these in under different categories, so you can add any one of these blocks and save yourself a bunch of time. Nancy, sorry, I missed the question. Where can you add a portal? You can add a portal anywhere because it gives you the URL. So if I just go back to Groove Member, yeah, you've got the URL, you can add it anywhere. Sorry, my phone is just opening Google for some reason. So if I click into portals again, you can see here, I mean, I can create another one and I can add a set of specific courses, but here's the login link. And if I paste that, so I could share that as a, just wherever you want. You can share it under videos, under promos, whatever you want. For example, let's, oh, I don't know what I did there. Where did I go? Oh, maybe I didn't click it. Apologies, that gave me the link from the file that I had. That's better. So let's say, for example, let's say I was giving away my profit funnel business, my funnel inside a group. I could talk to someone about it on a video, and I could send them here, for example, because I'm kind of promoting more than one thing. Obviously, my 10-day Groovy challenge, I'm not running live at the moment, so apologies. That is, like, a few links of that are places, but I could share this where people then could go and download and log in, etc. So yeah, you can do whatever you want with that, Nancy. Once you've got it, you can place that anywhere. Where was I? So now we have, we covered blocks. Let's go into elements. So now you can see all these elements. I can drag any one of these onto the page, and you see the little pink line is kind of telling me where it's gonna go. Do I want it up here? Do I want it down here? And just let go, and that will then populate over here. I don't want it there, so I'm just gonna actually click back until it goes. It's gone. Also, if you don't see what you're looking for here, don't forget that you can click on these over here and it's gonna give you more options. It's gonna give you lots of different things over here that you won't normally see. And then you have your settings. So this is your page settings, your SEO, your styling, tracking codes, redirect. Then you can go into your site-wide settings. That's where you can add your favicon. So if I open this up, you should see my favicon once I go away from it. See this little thing here? So our favicon is like the little feather with the ink blotter. I can't really think, so you can see it just there. It's just a dummy one I put in place. I created this logo whilst I sat on the beach. I kind of like it though. It's kind of cool because Maktub is the definition. It's you know what? My brain's gone dead. I can't even explain. So yeah, site settings are here. SEO, styling, tracking. You can share your site, so you can set this up and share it with someone. You can export and you can add instant edit bookmarklets. Look in the training area for those. So that is GroovePage. I could spend hours on this. I really could, but we don't have time. So I'm going to come back out of there. How am I doing for time? Okay, I'm 5 minutes to keep within the hour. And I'm on here as long as needed, by the way, guys. I only say an hour just because I'm very conscious of when someone tunes in, it's their time. Go away. Why did you suddenly pop up? I didn't ask for you to pop up. Oh my God. Sometimes, does anyone else get impatient like I do? So now let's say you've set your website up. Now you want to sell a product. So let's go into GrooveSell. It looks like someone is, oh, okay. I thought someone had asked an additional question, but they haven't. So let's go into GrooveSell. So this is where you're going to create your product or your service or your whatever it is. Same kind of layout. You've got all your quick links across the top. You can go and look at your stats over here. Here you can go into product funnels. And this is where you're going to set up your product originally. And you're just going to click on new product. I'm just going to use this demo one here. And it's going to open up the first time here. It's going to give you 11 steps. So you can see here, 11 steps. That's all you need to do to create your product. And you just follow the instructions. You add your image, you add your product name, your internal name for you to see, then your product description. Is it a front end? Is it an upsell? Is it an order bump? And it will say save a next view the first time. If you click save a next and the page doesn't move, it will highlight one of these boxes and say, look, you've missed something. So because I've already completed this one, it allows me to then go in and chop and change. So you can go into all of these. Just walk through it. It's really simple. Again, this is where you set up your affiliate account so you can activate an affiliate program. You're going to set all your settings in here. It's really simple. You can set up your proof widget that pops up on the page. Really simple to do. So if I go back all the way to the beginning, now you can see here, you can manage your products. You can manage your checkout links for this product, your sales, your coupons, your affiliate setup and promo tools, your affiliate performance, your affiliate payouts, and you can set up leaderboards. So that's all within these product funnels. You have partner contracts, your partner contract distributions. Here you can go in and manage your affiliates. That's obviously if you're creating an affiliate promo, so you want other people to promote your product, your service, etc. Here you can go and look at your customers, your cart abandons. Again, I've got it on demo mode. Your reporting, your transactions, and your reports. Here you have all your tools, so you can set up your checkout links. So for example, here you can set up all your tracking, affiliate portals, tools, leaderboards, coupons, tracking links, page tracking. Again, that's the marketplace. And again, here is all of your settings to manage your domains, your Facebook conversion pixels, and your self-billing. Whew, I flew through that. Any questions on GroovePage or GrooveSell or GrooveMember or Groove? I'm kind of opening it up because we're nearly the end. Groove Video, I feel like it's kind of overlooked a little bit. I've got two other softwares that I pay for that are the equivalent of Groove Video. And I'll show you what I mean by that. But when you come in here, same layout, quick links, plays, into the library. I'm just going to come in and edit this one. This was my Groove AI launch. This was my bonuses page video. So you can see this is how it played on my video sales letter or my opt-in page for my Groove AI bonuses. I know this because this was my apartment in Guadalajara. I've moved a few times since then. And you just go through, again, same process. Complete these steps to add the video, add a name, category, description. You can personalize to add the colors of your branding for all the play buttons, etc., that I don't have visible. You can add thumbnails, watermarks. You just click the save and next button. Here again, you can change all of this. So you can mute on start, you can unmute, you can autoplay. So this is how it plays. So it starts grabbing people's attention because they're like, well, what's going on here? I'm missing this. And you can see you can change these icons here. from within the dashboard. In fact, I've just got rid of that one. That was silly. Why did I do that? No, that's wrong. So you can add your own image. Sorry, I'm messing around with it. There, it's back. You can change the animation, the way it moves, save the next. But this is the bit that's exciting. You can add a text overlay, for example, let's say at 1 minute, I can add the text pop up on the screen, the video to stop, and it to say, enter your information below to get the extended version of this video, or enter your information below to get the free training I've just talked about. And I can add a button come up, and I can add a URL, and I can grab their information. I could do it on a membership if I wanted to. This is what I use the other software that I've got for. So you can add a banner, a text overlay. This for me is like way above anything else. It stops you having to use YouTube. You've obviously got a video embed then of this, a video hosted URL, so you can send people directly to that one specific video if that maybe had the text overlay on it. I know this video is designed for a video sales letter, but you know, you could do that, and you also have the source URL file. So for me, Groove Video is really super cool. Again, you have your analytics and your categories and your settings over here. So last but very much not least is Groove Webinar. It is nearly there. Groove Webinar, you can currently run a automated webinar. So if I click into the same thing, exactly the same lookout, I don't even need to explain that anymore. If I go into my webinars, you saw my crypto bot webinar is running, currently it's running on Webinar Jam, or Ever Webinar. It's one of Mike's original companies. So I know that Groove Webinar is gonna be as good, if not better, than Webinar Jam and Ever Webinar. So just for example, this is my team moving this across here. You can see the live, the stream, and the meeting are all coming soon, but you can run an automated, and you've just got to complete these sections here, and then you're set up, ready to go. So yeah, my team are moving that across. Then as you come down, you can set up surveys within here to go in the webinar. You can set up polls, you just create a new poll. You can add all your presenters, and you can look at your analytics, and then you've got your settings here as well. Canned responses are for an auto webinar. So my recommendation, if you're gonna run an auto webinar, you'd run the webinar 5, 6, 7 times live with an audience, and you'd find genuine questions that are asking at certain points, and then you can add those questions in here to make this look less of an automated webinar. You're never gonna lie, you're never gonna tell people it's live when it's not, but you want the comments to be coming in that are relevant to where you are in the webinar, if that makes sense. I'm just gonna cancel a few of these. And then last but not least, step 17, I'm gonna go through those in a moment. This is about support, but I'm gonna go back to step number 5. So it's completing that domain registration, or validation, should I say. So going back into domains, you'll see it here. So we need to click to verify. It's gonna ask us to double check. We've already done this step, if you remember rightly. We added Dora and Major into our name server records over here. You can see them there in GoDaddy. Other name domain providers are available. We're going to click validate DNS, and now you see successfully verified, which gave it a little bit of time, but we're not done yet. Now we need to choose the primary app that we want to use with that domain. And you can see you can choose any of the apps. I am going to keep it in Groove Pages because this domain is going to be set up in Groove Pages. But then once that's done, now you'll see you can go in and set up a subdomain, for example, GrooveSell. So let's put purchase as the subdomain, click the tick button, and then you'll see very quickly, boom, that's done. So now I've got subdomain purchase.maktub.com. And you can do the same with Groove Member, Groove Blog, and Groove Cart. But the last step that we need to do, which is step 16, adding your MX and CNAME records. Now we can see the DNS is available. Obviously, you can set up your 404 page. That's if someone clicks a link that's not correct, it will take you there. You can delete it if you wanted to, which I'm not going to, but you can add your DNS records now. So Google, for example, will give you a bunch of CNAME records. It'll give you this and this, and it'll ask you to add them all here. That's how you connect Groove Mail with your professional email account. My own site hosting that I've got, they asked me to add MX records and also text records, and they give me those as well. dependent on what you need, is dependent on, even for example, like validating your domain with Google and adding it to Google. They'll give you a CNAME record, I think it is, and they'll give you the code to add in here to confirm. So now you have the access to it. You can go in and edit all of these DNS records. So that was the last step we hadn't done. How did I do on time? I'm 4 minutes over. That's not bad. So any questions, I'm opening up the floor completely now to any questions about anything. If it's too advanced, then I'll probably just park you and you know, push you back to support. But I'm here and available. I'll put my camera on back down into the bottom right corner just so you know I'm still live. So the last bit I want help from you with is support supporting you. Let me repeat that. I want you to support us in supporting you. And what I mean by this is, we get so many support tickets. Our ticketing system gets overrun sometimes, and 97% of them are very, very basic questions that we got training on. We got training in the YouTube channel, in the Digital Academy, in the help desk, everywhere, in the Facebook group. And unfortunately, users end up being a bit lazy and just going to support. I'm asking you not to do that. So here's the order I recommend. First things first, just go to the Groove AI assistant. He sat here. He's available in your dashboard 24/7. He doesn't sleep. He doesn't eat. He doesn't need a break. Go in here, ask him your question. 90% of the time, he gives you the correct answer. So that would be the first port of call. If he doesn't give you the correct answer, obviously, you can take a screenshot, send it to support anyway, so we can modify that. The next place you should go to is go into the Digital Academy. So down here, the little teacher's cap, click in here, open the Digital Academy, either search by typing in the question or search by app specific and find your training specific video for your answer. So those are the first two. If you haven't found it still by that point, then go into the help desk. You'll see down here, the help desk is the question mark. Click to open the support help desk. Obviously search here, the little AI chatbot is going to pop up. Just go and search in the knowledge base, or you can search through all of these videos here as well. So there's three places we've gone so far and we've not had to bother support. Then ask in the Facebook community, because I'm myself and many other people are admins in the Facebook group. We'll either approve your post and answer it directly in the comments straight away, or we'll approve it and one of the other super users will do it if we don't have time, if we're on the run, or we might decline it with feedback, which means we're answering it direct to your messenger account. So look in your message requests. If you don't see your post has been approved, doesn't mean we've got anything against you or we don't answer your question. It just might mean that we've answered that question like 20 times that week and we just don't want to clutter the group up. Then if after those four things you haven't found your solution, then go and put a support ticket in. So just click over here, sorry, to the help desk. Click in here, it opens up a new window. We know our AI chatbot's going to pop up. We can see the chat is popped up over here. We're just going to get rid of him. If you get rid of him by accident, it pops up here again, instant AI support. And then we're going to click chat support and we're going to click ask. And then if it's within the EST times that our support team work, then you'll see this chat box will pop up. It's going to ask you for your email and then your question. Do it that way. Or sometimes it might just show email. That's the only option because the chat team are offline and you go in here. My recommendation, be as descriptive as possible. Remember, your support team has sat there. They've never spoken to you. They've got any idea what you do, what business you run, what niche you're in. And we see some of the questions and it takes us four or five backwards and forwards just to find out what the actual issue is. So be descriptive, put lots of content, I'm in Groove pages. I clicked into this website, name this. I clicked into the page, name this. When I click in settings and I go into the description, that's the detail you need. So the support person can go, they can log in your account and go, boom, boom, boom. Yeah, I see the problem. Here's the answer. Or for me, record a Loom video as well, because you can put the URL in here and it means the support team can then give you the answer. Quick, easy, and efficient. And it doesn't clog them up with doing four or five messages backwards and forwards, which takes time. If you want the answer quickly, follow this process. So that's me asking you for a favor so that we don't clog our support team up, so that when you do have a genuine issue, we can get the answer to you quickly. Hope that makes sense. And then obviously, where's the support available? I've shown you pretty much four or five times, but I'm going to show you again. So chat support in the Groove dashboard. You can go into the help desk here, as we just showed. just give it a moment. It will pop up here in the bottom corner. That's the easiest way. And then Digital Academy as well. You can get access through there. You'll see it will pop up in the top right corner here, contact support, and just follow the instructions. And then the AI instant support, obviously you already know he's in the dashboard here, and he's also in the help desk. And is he in the Digital Academy? I can't remember now if we've added him in the Digital Academy as well. I don't know if he pops up. This isn't him. This is one of my applications. So no, he doesn't actually pop up in there. And then AI support from the community, obviously in the inside the Facebook group, pop your questions in there, follow the rules, you know, and you know, be a good user. Let me get rid of that. In fact, let me just quickly now, I'm gonna give you a copy of this doc and I'm gonna add it into, copy link. I'm gonna add it into Facebook Direct, and then I'll do the same for YouTube download doc. And if someone who is in Facebook can just click on that and see if it will download, that would be much appreciated. It's in the comments. And I'm going to go into YouTube and do the same over there. If someone could just let me know they can see that and it's clickable. And I'm just going to come back over here because we've pretty much finished on screen now. I'm just going to check my doc. Yeah, that's pretty much it. In fact, the only thing I didn't share, which was step number 16. There's a full Groove orientation. Elliot's done a nice walkthrough of all the applications. He takes a little bit more time. I try and go as quick as I can, purely because I'm conscious of your time. I could sit here for 3 hours and do this live and answer hundreds of questions. But I know that not everyone wants to sit on a long, long, long live. I try and get it under an hour. I'm just over today. But yeah, there's a nice walkthrough here. I'm pretty sure it's about 29 minutes. Go and watch that with Elliot as well. If there are no other questions in the chat, then I will wrap up for today. This will normally get added into the Facebook group. I have been having issues with Facebook. I don't know if anyone else finds the same. I get a lot of glitches in Facebook. A lot. For example, I would like to add this in the guide section. I'm just looking on my other screen just to show you. I'd like to add it into the guide section where I used to add all of these lives. So if you click into guides, you'll see there is a previous from June live. But since they did an update, I now am unable to add the lives in here. But you can go back in here. You can see these are all the feature requests, the improved features, the code refinement videos that I've done over the last. Obviously, these are all the updates. So anytime you need to, you can access those in here. I will try and add this most recent live here, but it does stay within the group. So you can always just come back into the group and search for it, and you can watch this back through at your own pace. So yeah, unless there are any additional questions, good, it's there. Thank you, Nancy. You don't have to show me how I can go to support, but can GrooveCM do quiz funnels? The AI chat says it can, but I haven't seen any info on it in the knowledge base. Yeah, the answer is yes. Let me share my screen for a second. A quiz funnel, it doesn't have the specific functionality yet. I know that it's something that they've talked about, but let me just show you for an example. So a quiz funnel is just realistically asking you a few questions and walking people through a process. Now, did I do it on this one? So I clicked on this one. This is a website built for a client. Now, did I? No, I don't think I did. Which one was it? I wanted to show you a quiz funnel that I had started for a client where we're just taking them through like questions, and each question diverts them to a different answer. And obviously it takes them a different route, which spits them out at the end to a different sales video. I think it was this one. So I just wanted to show you, Jeff, just to give you an idea. Now, the problem with this, it does get quite complicated. This is for our events business. Let me see. I don't know if this is live or if this will actually work. So I just wanted to try and give you an idea. So let's say someone's on our events website and they're saying they want to do something. So obviously the first thing I added was their So let's grab their name and email. Again, I have no idea if this is live. This goes, so you can see at the top there, it's step one of six. Now it goes to step two of six. So this now, and again, you can see we've got like a how far they've gone in the process. So this was for asking people who wanted to rent a bell tent. So now they can select, again, it's got a little bit of text explaining, but it kind of becomes quite obvious. Okay, I want a 5 meter bell tent. It should, okay, it is working. I wasn't sure if we'd finish this. So now you can see step three of six. So now they're like, okay, do I want a single bell tent? Do I want multiple? Because we rent to a lot of weddings and events. So let's say we're going to go for an event. Now, do we want it as a day hire? So do we want it just for 24 hours? I think we do day hire and then we do an overnight hire. So let's say I want an overnight hire. And then do we want it 1 day, 3 days, or other? So let's go to other. And do we want the tents to be styled? Sorry, no styling, full styling. Do we want the romance package, the movie? So does that make sense, Jeff? I'm just trying to give you, this is a quiz funnel. And then it should, again, I have no idea. So now it's spat me out based on, now let me just show you, just to show how complex this starts getting. These are the pages within this funnel. And I'm just scrolling, you should be able to see them. Now, each one of these I've named slightly different so I know where it goes, what it's relevant for. There will be a bunch of pages that I need to know it's going to go to. So because of the order that this person's gone through, I need this order page to be relevant. So they chose a 5 meter bell tent, they wanted an overnight stay, and they wanted no styling. So this gives them that exact order page where they can get that. And you can see on here, we've given them other options as well if they want to increase the night stays and et cetera, et cetera. But that is a quiz funnel. So yeah, you can do it. I just thought I'd quickly show you how that's possible. Hope that makes sense. And I hope that I had the screen shared. I did. Yes, it makes sense. Perfect. So unless there are any other questions, I'm open to staying on and answering any other questions. Unless there are any other, I'm going to wrap up and let you finish off your day. And I'll give you a few seconds. I'll have a little drink of water. I do these every Tuesday. Now I'm back in Mexico. They'll probably go back to the original time, which you'll see me post after this today. I'll set them up again. This normally 2 p.m. Eastern time, I think, but don't quote me on that because I'm in CST. So I'm just buying time to see if there's any other questions. Otherwise, I'm probably going to finish off with our little outro and leave you to your day. But yeah, I do these every week on a Tuesday. Really important when you're working online from home, keep yourself hydrated. I drink one of these large cups of water straight out of my water machine every hour. Okay, I'm not seeing anything else. So I'm going to wrap up with, where's my little outro? I think that is my little outro there. So yeah, have an awesome day. And I'm gonna finish off with this.